Hourglass Science, 2 minutes on the hourglass. Again, I'm going to return to my hand to talk about the neuron, the nerve cell that we're all commonly used to. And for this one, I'm using a motor neuron to explain how my arm is set up. And I'm going to name the pieces so that we have a common language and where these names might actually come from. If you look at these parts of my hand, my fingers, these would be the dendrites. And dendrite means tree in Greek. So these are the branching offs of all of the cell body, which reach out to all the other neurons and connect with those axon terminals before it. These are what receive the messages to be able to go down. This part of my hand, my palm, would be the soma or cell body. Soma really means body. If you look at the middle of it, it would have a nucleus buried inside of it, and that's where most of the organelles, everything would be inside that cell body, as if it was a normal cell, typical cell, I should say. This wrist, where I have this little line here in my wrist, is the axon hillock. This axon hillock is where the cell combines with the axon. And this part of my arm would actually be a thin cord that would stretch out and end in terminals like this. Just the same way that the dendrites were, it would be axon terminals. Terminal means to end, and axon, if you think about an axis, if you think about a straight line, that is where it's coming out as far as this long extension of the cell body. Sometimes in certain neurons, you have what's called a myelin sheath. And those myelin sheaths are actually other cells that wrap around the axon to be able to insulate it. So when the message fires, it goes faster. It makes sure that whenever you have the message going from chemical, it goes electrical. And those insulatory cells, which are pretty much fat cells of glia, those are myelin cells. And those myelin sheaths wrap the entire axon.